Jack looked at his body and limbs critically. "It strikes me you made a very good job of it," he remarked.
"Just so-so," replied Tip modestly, for he began to see certain defects in the construction of his man. "If I'd known we were going to travel together, I might have been a little more particular."
"Why, then," said the Pumpkinhead, in a tone that expressed surprise, "you must be my creator, my parent, my father."
"Or your inventor," replied the boy with a laugh. "Yes, my son, I really believe I am."
"Then I owe you obedience," continued the man, "and you owe me support."
"That's it exactly," declared Tip, jumping up. "So let us be off."
"Where are we going?" asked Jack, when they had resumed their journey.
"I'm not exactly sure," said the boy, "but I believe we are headed south, and that will bring us, sooner or later, to the Emerald City."
"What city is that?" inquired the Pumpkinhead.
"Why, it's the center of the Land of Oz, and the biggest town in all the country. I've never been there myself, but I've heard all about its history. It was built by a mighty and wonderful wizard named Oz, and everything there is of a green color, just as everything in this country of the Gillikins is of a purple color."
"Is everything here purple?" asked Jack.
"Of course it is, can't you see?" returned the boy.
"I believe I must be color blind," said the Pumpkinhead, after staring about him.
"Well, the grass is purple, and the trees are purple, and the houses and fence are purple," explained Tip. "Even the mud in the roads is purple. But in the Emerald City, everything is green that is purple here. And in the country of the Munchkins over to the east, everything is blue. And in the south country of the Quadlings, everything is red. And in the west country of the Winkies, where the Tin Woodman rules, everything is yellow."